We're going to start you off with some happy music, as Paul requested. This is one of my favorites that Zara sings. It's a Patsy Cline tune called Love Me, Honey Do.
Yeah. Are we ready?
One, two, three.
Well, you know, we love the classic country, but we're gonna do a tune that I wrote now, and this is one. Actually, you know, most of my love experiences have been very positive. But luckily for me, as a country singer, you know, there was only one scoundrel, and at least I got one song out of it. It's called Run Home and Cry.
For years I've listened to your moan about wanting me, but getting bones about how the world just doesn't understand. Well, you used up all my sympathy when I caught you stepping out on me. So cry now, baby, find someone who cares. I want two, three, run home and cry. Yes, the other day when you were late,
move on to the songwriting of Jesse Milnes over here now. He's pretty prolific and awesome songwriter. Sometimes he takes his material from real life, other times it's completely imaginary, like this next Girl Fight song. He couldn't possibly have gotten his material from anything real life. It's called Looking for a Fight.
Looking for a fight. I'm talking about tonight. Oh, you know where to find me. Yeah, you know where to find me. If you wanna get nasty, I'm talking about tragic. Oh, you know where to find me. Yeah, you know where to find me. If you wanna get
one that I just wrote this summer, this is one that I wrote for Jesse Milnes over here on the occasion of our wedding back in June. That was very nice. And my bandmates will attest that I am a rather clumsy person, and I tend to make lots of awkward mistakes. Like currently I have a burn on the back of my neck that I got from exploding soup. And you may ask, how did exploding soup get on the back of your neck? Well, I don't know either, but apparently I'm really good at getting in the way of exploding soup. Stuff like that happens to me all the time. And there's probably something I should learn from my mistakes. But anyway, I choose to think that I used up all my luck in my love life, and I just don't have room for any other luck. So, this is called I Got Lucky With You.
One, two. drive for miles looking for that New York parking spot. By the time I whip a smoking trend, it's hardly ever high. And the most I've ever wanted cards was a $7 pot. You may ask if I regret these things, but I assure you I do not.
On the drums. You probably met her before. You may not have met the lovely PJ George on the bass back here. He played in this very room with a great band called Barefoot a few years ago, right?
Yep.
A couple years ago. And we're so happy to have him. And this is Zara Bodie here. And Emily Miller, you're the Sweetback Sisters. So I hope Paul didn't actually promise only happy songs, because we're going to do a sad song now. But it's a really beautiful one by the great Hazel Dickens. This is one we put on our Looking for a Fight record. It's just one of my favorites that she wrote. It's called Don't Put Her Down. Anybody ever get a chance to hear Hazel Dickens in concert? Zara did. I never did. Two of you.
Three of you.
You're very lucky. I never got to hear her, but I grew up listening to her records. She put out a bunch of two or three great records with Alice Gerard in the 80s called Hazel and Alice. And Anyway, here we go. Don't put her down.
You pull the string. She's your plaything. You can make her or break her.
Thank you.
your day. Don't put her down, you help her lay.
A writer from my home state of California, and it's one very lovely lady by the name of Laura Lewis, and this is called Texas Bluebonnets.
I recently found out that Laura put out this record on Signature a while back, on Signature Sounds, our lovely label that we love so much, based out of Northampton now. She put a Christmas record out on Signature a few years ago called Winter's Grace. And that's another thing we have in common with Laura Lewis. We put out a Christmas record on Signature last year, too. We were just talking about it over dinner. It's never too early to get talking about Christmas. It's so fun. Actually,
apparently,
while it's on my mind, I want to let you all know that we're really, really excited. We've been growing the Christmas show every year. And this year, for the first time, we're going to be at the Academy of Music. Which is crazy, and so I really, 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 really hope you all will come, because it's really big.
Basically, for every person that's ever come, they have to bring four of their friends.
Yeah. It's gonna be great. It's so huge. We're gonna have a huge Christmas tree. It's gonna be like the most fun thing ever. We've been scheming. There's talk of children's choirs. There's talk of Santa. It's gonna be fun. So, not to give it all away, but please come to the Academy of Music
for the Country Christmas Sing-Along Spectacular.
I think it's December 21st.
I think it's the... Yes, I think you're right. Or it's the 20th. I think it's the 20th. It's either one of those days. Woo! I'm so glad you're excited too. Okay, here we go. The Texas Bluebonnets.
Yeah.
Well, we're going to do another one that that Jesse wrote now. This is one called Thank You. And it's the only country song I know that talks about... actually, no, it's one of two country songs I know that talk about driving on I-95. But they're both written by West Virginians, so I don't really know what that's about.
Fascinating
with this crazy thing called an interstate. There is one in West Virginia. There's one. Two? What's the second one? Three? Wow. Amazing. There's I-79, 64. 77. Wow.
81 puts a little bit of West Virginia.
70. Wow. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have even gone there. West Virginia knows a lot about interstates.
A lot of interstates.
Anyway, this is called Thank You. Doesn't talk about any of those ones. Bulldog, isn't it true? Isn't that not true? I think it's true. And I think. And so we have a brand new EP. It's a 7-song EP. And those of you who have been coming to Sweetback Sisters shows for a while know that we love to play traditional music sort of in the Sweetback Sisters style. But up until now, we hadn't ever recorded any of that traditional music. So last summer, we went to Virginia, right across the border from West Virginia, practically West Virginia. And we went to Floyd, Virginia, and we recorded this EP, we included some of our favorite songs that we had been performing in the band, and then we arranged some new traditional songs specifically for the EP, many of them from West Virginia, like this next song. We're going to close out this first set with two songs from that Bulldog EP. And this first one is from West Virginia. It comes from a guy named Currence Hammonds, who lived in Huttonsville, West Virginia, which is about 10 minutes south of where Jesse and I live. And Jesse's dad, Jerry Milnes, knew Currence. Jesse's parents used to live in Huttonsville, too. Jerry met Currence and learned a lot of banjo tunes from him and heard a lot of stories and learned several great songs from him. And Currence was a moonshiner, tells this great story about the feds coming to bust him for moonshining and him like laying himself over the still to hide the glint of the copper from the coppers. So he knew what he was talking about, and this is a song he sang called The Moonshiner. So here it is.
He's been a moonshiner for many long years. He spent all his money on whiskey and beer, and his breath is as sweet
We'll do one now. Our last one before the break will be another one off of the Bulldog EP. In fact, this will be the title track called I've Got a Bulldog. And this is one that, if you feel inclined to sing along, you know, warm yourself up for the Country Christmas Sing-Along Spectacular, you may. And it's really, the form is really easy. So Zara sings a line, and then we repeat it, and then we repeat that again, I think. And then she sings another line, and we repeat that as well. So it's really, I don't even know the words to this song. You can just follow along with me. And then during the break, we have the Bulldog EP for sale. We have brand new merchandise. We have these chicken bags. This is the first show we've had them at. They are beautiful tote bags with chickens silk screened on them. And we also have a new printing of our chicken t-shirts that just arrived a couple days ago too. And now we have up into several XL sizes and we have red and white, and they're so cute, and I recommend checking them out. And then we also have some solo CDs. Jesse has a solo CD. I have a brand new duet CD with my mother that just came out, and our old CD with my mother. I think we have one copy of our CD with Jesse's dad of traditional West Virginia music, so if you want that, it's back there. Anyway, there's so many things, and there's watermelon, so you probably won't even want any of that, because you're just going to be eating watermelon. It's so great. So we're going to do this last tune, Bulldog, and then we'll be back with a whole second set of music after the break, after the watermelon. Ukes are notorious. I mean, not only is it a uke, but it's a banjo uke. You just can't win.
Can't win. New tuners, new strings.
So. Yeah, oh, totally. It's not, no. It's just the world conspiring.
I got bulldog cuss 500. I got bulldog cuss 500. Thank you.
second. So I think we need to have one more song before the watermelon will be ready. It's not ready. We can't rush watermelons to rule. So we're gonna do one more song
before we take that break.
And that song is gonna be Rockabye,
how about? Because we can start the next song with the next tune. Yeah.
We'll do for you, for the watermelon really. It's for everybody's sake. We're gonna do a tune now it's also a new one we have never recorded on a CD. And
just a second.
And this one's called the Rockabye Boogie. It's one of my favorites. It comes from the group that we kind of modeled ourselves after when we first started the band. There's a group called the Davis Sisters that we loved, adored, and this is one of their tunes. I just have to grab my fiddle, just a second.
Don't go anywhere.
This is a new fiddle on this tour, and so I'm constantly worried it's gonna like beat and like just have gone totally out of tune when I pick up the fiddle. So I have to remind myself, pick it up early, Jack. Sounds beautiful. Okay. The Rockabye Boogie.
One, two, one, two, three.
Rockabye boogie, 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 rockabye boogie.
Actually, you can hear it. Just say loud. This is...
I'm Ryan Hummel.
From
Northampton, Mass. Fun fact.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I should have. You guys better clap really loud for the last person so they don't feel bad, even though they aren't from Northampton. And fun fact is that Ryan Hummel's third grade teacher from Amherst.
Amherst,
Massachusetts.
Yeah,
is here tonight in the audience. Where are you? How are you? Back there we have Stephan Amidon.
Attleboro, Vermont. Yeah.
Back there, you met PJ George, who is from?
Salem, Virginia.
We've got Jesse Milnes over there from Elk. Oh, sorry, you get to say that.
Elkins, West Virginia.
Okay, I'm going to do me first. Because. So I am Emily Miller, and I also live in Elkins, West Virginia, but I'm from Lawrence, Kansas originally. And over here we have Zara Bodie from
Brattleboro, Vermont.
But Zara went to high school and some of elementary and middle school in Florence and Northampton, Massachusetts. And dun, 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 dun. My third grade teacher is also here.
What are the odds?
And one of my favorite third grade teacher friends is also here in the back. We've got Erica Morse. She didn't teach me, but I kind of wish she had. So we're going to start with a song by Zara Bodie over here. This is called Just That Kind of Guy. I mentioned in the first half that I got married this summer, and getting married kind of makes you think about saying that things are forever, and that's a good thing in my case. That was sort of, you know, it's a long time to think about, and so that sort of got me thinking. This is a song called "Forever, One Day at a Time."
So we're gonna start with that.
And it goes like a little something like this right here. Jesse and Stefan up here, and we're gonna break it down into an acapella number now. And this is another one off of our Bulldog EP, and it's called Blues Fighters. This is another one that comes from West Virginia, and the story goes that Jesse learned all of the words to this song as like a 4-year-old, and he was a big hit family reunions. So yeah, it's called the Blues Fighters.
Well, come all you booze fighters if you want to hear about the kind of booze that we sell around here. It's made out of buckwheat, rye, and corn, and all bottled up in some old barn. Well, we don't give a dang for the Volstead law,
and for prohibition we don't care at all. It's made way back in the swamps and the hills, where there's plenty of moonshine stills. And the llama laid down with the lion after drinking this old moonshine.
Well, one drop will make a rabbit with a bulldog.
One drop will make a cat chase a wild hog. Make a bullfrog spit in a black snake's face and make a hard-shelled creature fall from grace. And the lamb will lay down with the lion after drinking this old moonshine.
Well, you tip up your head and you take a little drink.
And then for a week you won't be able to think. And the next thing you know, you'll be getting kind of tight. Out on the streets trying to raise a fight. So you tip up your head and you take a little more. And then for a month you'll be feeling kind of sore. And then you'll swear you won't drink it anymore. But you said that 1,000 times before. And the lamb will lay down with the lion after drinking this old moonshine.
So we're going to do follow it up with another song off the Bulldog EP. This is a great fiddle tune from West Virginia called Walking in My Sleep. Is the guitar coming through the... Oh no, it's got the tuner on. Now is it coming through there? Excellent. No, it's great. I just had the tuner on. Walking in My Sleep.
Thank you.
And that was Ryan Hummel ripping up the electric guitar. And so the answer to how we met and got together, that's sort of like a little bit long and complicated, but the like one sentence answer is that Zara and I met in the Hamburg airport on, it's true, true story, and but we had both been hired to be part of a choir. We were both in the alto section. We arrived in Hamburg, shook each other's hands, and then proceeded to travel around Europe together for 3 months singing choral music. It was great, it was beautiful. That was in 2005, and then in 2006, we started hanging out in Brooklyn. I moved to Brooklyn, and we started hanging out and singing country songs together. And my roommate heard us, and he had a gig at this place called Freddy's Bar and Backroom. He was like, hey, do you guys want to have this gig at Freddy's Bar and Backroom with me? And we said, sure, we better get a band, though. And so we got Stefan to come, and Jesse, and you were there, and you were there. It's like the Wizard of Oz. And then more recently...
I'm Glinda.
I'm obviously Auntie M. And then, you know, when you play country music, you meet other great country musicians. So we met Ryan through our first electric guitar player, Ross, and we met him here in Amherst. And we met PJ on the road in Nashville. Yeah, so that's how it all happened. That was the origin story. We'll make a prequel someday. Prequel to the Sweetback. We won't make a biopic. We'll just make like a childhood story. One. Okay, here we go. What we're gonna sing?
It won't hurt.
It won't hurt. We're gonna sing a tune off of our Looking for a Fight record. This is one by the great Dwight Yoakam. It's called It Won't Hurt When I Fall Down from This Bar Stool.
Because this whiskey is misery. But even
Jesse's getting that guitar on, I wanted to let you know that I am really excited that you all live here in Western Massachusetts, and there's so much great music that happens here. Like, looking at the schedule for the Parlor Room in Northampton, which is so great, it's like one of my favorite places to see music. I don't even live here, and I've seen a ton of shows there. I live in West Virginia. That's a really long commute. But next Wednesday, Cedric Watson and Bijou Creole, so amazing. Then later, let's see, who else do I know? Meg Hutchinson, such a great singer-songwriter, so beautiful. Rashad Eggleston, our fellow Signature Sounds label mate, well, he's not even Crooked Still. Well, anyway, former label mate, Rashad Eggleston, cello crazy man. Literally, I just watched a ton of Rashad YouTube videos the other day, including a song. I don't know if this will encourage you to go to the show or discourage you, but there's this song that he wrote called I Peed on a Bird, and it goes like this. So here's how it goes. It's actually a beautiful story. So the song starts like, I went up to a cliff, and I was looking out at the beautiful sunset, and then I had to pee, and so I peed, and I peed on a bird. And then it goes on for about 4 minutes, singing, and I peed on a bird. I peed on a bird. And shockingly, it's really moving and a beautiful song. So you can do that, guys. Okay, I'm not done, because Ronnie Arbo, so amazing. We totally adore Ronnie. The Neils. This is just October, guys. This is crazy. Nora Jane Struthers, we love her. She played here with Barefoot, too. Tim Erickson, such an incredible singer. Session Americana, this is like blowing my mind, guys. Lindsay Lou and the Flatbellies, I've never actually had the pleasure of seeing them live, but I've heard they're amazing.
I believe Aaron, you can pick up this exact piece of paper at that table.
Are you saying I shouldn't read this out loud to everybody?
I think you have.
Aaron McEwen. Aaron McEwen. I was skipping some. No, October 26th.
Yeah.
All of this is coming up.
Woo! Be there.
I didn't know if I would ever get to. I have to tell Rashad Eggleston that I sang I Peed on a Bird on stage. Because I basically just sang the whole song for you, except the lyrics at the beginning are much more poetic when he does it. Okay, here we go. We're going to have Stefan sing you a song.
Let's sing a song by Josh Ritter called The Deputy Blues Number 2.
Can you hear him?
Can you hear me?
Yeah. All right.
Hello,
hello. Let's turn him up. Let's turn him up a little bit.
Yeah.
Do you know how to find him?
Where is he? Which one are you?
I think he's the back one on the right.
Yeah, all the way back. Hello, hello.
Yeah.
Can you hear me now? I mean, the answer is yes already, so.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Hot fuzz buddy to keep some times. Hot fuzz buddy to keep some times. Hot fuzz lover who leaves on times. When she doesn't gotta catch her, when she doesn't gotta hold.
Your hair and it's sitting in my locket and it keeps me company. Well, she'll give for the brave man to return.
Well, we're getting down to the last few songs here in the set, and but you're in for a treat because this is really one of my favorite tunes we do. And we're gonna have Jesse sing you a song now. Woo. Now, am I correct that we're doing it in D? Yeah. Is that right?
Yeah.
Oh. You heard that memo? So Jesse Mellon's over here is an amazing finger-picking guitar player. He learned some finger-picking guitar from the great John Cephas from the Piedmont area of Virginia when he was a teenager, and just plays some of my favorite music in the whole world on that guitar. And in fact, that solo CD that is back there of his has a lot of really his awesome finger-picking on it, including this very song, in fact. It's called Brownsville. How about you just do a little test in there?
Test?
We can hear him, right?
I'm going down to Brownsville, take that ride. Till I bring my baby home. You know that I love that long and curly hair. You know that I love that long and curly hair. But her mother and father don't
one more song for you, but before we sing that song, I want to say a huge thank you to Paul for bringing us here. I don't see where Claudia is, but Claudia for having us over for a delightful dinner beforehand, and Paul too, both of you guys. We love Watermelon Wednesdays. It's so exciting that such a great concert series is happening here in Whately. We totally love it, and it's really amazing the acts you get here. I was looking at the schedule. I wasn't able to come. My parents came to the Bruce Molsky concert in August, and they said it was awesome. And Maeve Gilchrist and Tim O'Brien was here. Anybody here at the Tim O'Brien show? That probably was awesome. It's just so exciting to share the stage sort of over the summer with such amazing artists. We're very honored to be part of the series. And I hope that we see you all at the Academy of Music, remember? Yeah. Yeah, we're all, pinky swear, we're all gonna be there. It's gonna be so fun. And that's in December. And let's see, what else? Thank you all so much for coming tonight. It's been so great. So, we're gonna do this last song, another one by Jesse, and it's called I'm Gonna Cry.
On your behalf, I'm gonna
cry, lay right down, die. All my little hands up, rub my eyes, run back home, roll out in the bed, get my little notebook pen, write what you said. I'm gonna cry for you. Well,
position that you put me in, I'm gonna
cry, cry, lay right down, die. Oh, my little hands up, rub my eyes, run back home, roll out in the bed, get my little notebook in, write what you said. I'm gonna cry, cry, cry for you. Thank you.
gonna get my little notebook in. Follow you said I'm gonna cry.
This is called Rattled. I hope that it rattles you. We haven't taught PJ that song yet.
One, two, three.
I get rattled every time we meet. I get rattled even in my rattled, baby. Only you. I get it twisted, I get turned on. Baby.
baby, is there something wrong with you? Baby, 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 this is out of my control.